Hey, today I'm going to talk about brake fluids. And you know what? I've really been looking forward to this yarn. This is a really interesting topic because, for me, brake fluid is one of the most underestimated, underrated fluids in your car because it has such a profound impact on your braking. You might not think so, but that is absolutely the case. Now, you know, we're in a race environment here and absolutely it has evolved over many years and racing has been right at the forefront of that evolution because of the heat generated in the brakes. So let's understand them. From a specification point of view, you kind of start down at this end with what's called dot 3. Then there's dot 4, dot 5 and so on. That pretty well covers it, doesn't go far beyond that. Now, when we look at our brake fluids, let's understand the difference between the different grades and what's applicable. There's two fundamental differences as we go up the ladder. One is its boiling point. Just like boiling water, at what point does pure brake fluid actually boil? Now, a racing brake fluid obviously boils at a much higher temperature than your road car brake fluid. Now, we'll get to that. The other really critical thing, which is expensive to develop, is a brake fluid's propensity to absorb moisture. Now, all brake systems through seals and other mechanisms will absorb moisture into them. Moisture is a bad thing in a brake system because it does two things. One, it's going to lower, right, your boiling temperature of the pure fluid, right? That's going to come down because it's got water in it now, quite obviously. As a result of that boiling, vaporisation means your pedal is going to go soft, and that's a really bad thing. So when we talk about fluid specifically, at the lower end, dot 3. Now that's going to be perfectly fine in the vast majority of road cars for which it's used. Most manufacturers just specify that at a service schedule. But if you want to go up a step, you can go up to dot 4. You can see there the number 4 on it. Now that's different in that the boiling temperature is up a little bit and the propensity to absorb moisture is also less, which is a good thing. Now, that'd also be good, for example, if you've got some of the modern specifications call for it, that you might have a heavier brake application, or if you've got a load, a truck, whatever, or if you're towing a big old caravan and you're going down a hill and riding your foot on the brakes, can't think of a better way to get your brakes stinking hot and blue, boil your fluid. So that might be perfect if you're in a towing environment. Then we go to the next level of fluid, which is kind of in the modern era. This is called brake fluid, right? Dot 4, same as this, but ESP. That stands for electronic stability program. So many modern vehicles we know now have avoidance programs, anti-lock brake systems. Now, if you've ever put your foot on the brake and felt that in operation, you'll feel the frequency at which it applies the brake per times per second to maintain the grip of the tyre. A slipping tyre, remember, a lock tyre doesn't provide grip. So what that does, that has a variety of treatments in it and viscosity applicable to the really, really fast reaction required from the brake system in a modern braking system. So that's good for a modern car. And then we go up to racing brake fluid. Now, I can tell you, Davey Reynolds, who won Bathurst 2017, for 161 laps at the end of Conrod Straight at nearly 300 k's an hour, they generate just under 1,000 degrees centigrade brake temperature on the disc there, used that every single lap to stop him. So that's how good that stuff is. Do you need it in any road car? No, of course you don't, because you're just not going to generate that sort of heat. If you want to put it in there, by all means do it. It's not cheap as some of these ones, but it is very, very good. I'm not recommending you need it for your road car though. And then over here sitting out all on its own, silicon brake fluid. Now, don't confuse that with synthetic brake fluid. Most modern brake fluids are synthetic. This is silicon brake fluid, so it's actually a heavier brake fluid. It doesn't absorb any water at all, but it kind of has different properties. So that's best used where the manufacturer calls for its use in its particular application. But it is a good one. Now, there's plenty more information on all of these because I could be here for an hour talking about it. Jump on Penrite Oil's website and knock your socks off.